Every morning brings a new hope. Every morning brings a new scope. So take every day as a new day. One small positive thought in the morning can change your whole day. A very good morning to everyone present here. Wishing you all a best and glorious day ahead. Yesterday is not just a day of our dreams, and today is not just a day of an end. I'm profusely overjoyed to tell our KSA Women's College Tiruchengodu, PG Department of Commerce, organizes the grand national level 7-day virtual faculty development program on multidimensional approaches to research in social science. Today is the second golden day of that on the topic review of literature and protection from plagiarism by our today's valuable chief guest, Dr. P. Malyadri sir, ICSSR Senior Fellow, Research Advisor in Management and Commerce, Center for Economic, ICSSR Research Institute, Ministry of HRD, Government of India, Begumpet, Hyderabad. I deem it a great privilege to welcome you all from this great gathering. Prayer is a song of the heart that makes its way to the throne of God. Even when entangled in the wailing of thousands of souls, one who prays for the welfare of all is a true devotee. May I now call upon Ms. T.K. Dharani Priya from 1st MCOM Department, KSA Women's College, for the prayer song.
Ahaganada Kartagananada Kanivaha Arulpai Gajamuha Shivabala கணநாயகனே கரிமா முதலே ஜெய் கற்பகணித்தியே வருவாய் கணம் யாவிலுமே துணை நின்றிடுவாய் கஜமுக நாயகனே ஸ்ரீவரத விநாயக விக்ன விநாயக சக்கர விநாயக பெருமானி ஸ்ரீ அபய விநாயக அகில விநாயக ஆத்ம விநாயகனே கணநாதா கணநாதா கற்பக கணநாதா கனிவாக அருள்வாயே கஜமுக சிவபாலா.
Thank you, Ms. T.K. Dharani Priya, for your devotional start. Here is a hearty welcome, big and warm enough to encompass you all. May I now request Dr. E. Selvi Ma'am, Assistant Professor of BCom Department, KSA Women's College, to welcome the gathering, please, ma'am.
Very good morning to one and all gathered here. On this auspicious occasion, I would like to welcome you all for the 7-day virtual faculty development program on multidimensional approaches to research in social science, organized by PG Department of Commerce, KSR Women's College, Tiruchengodu. Stars shine at night, some stars shine at bright daylight. It's our pleasure to welcome our such a star, Honorable Line Dr. K.S. Rangasamy, MJS sir, founder and chairman. Welcome you, sir. It's my pleasure to welcome Mr. R. Srinivasan sir, Vice Chairman. Welcome you, sir. I greatly welcome Mr. Savita Srinivasan ma'am, Executive Director, who encourages in each and every activity. Welcome you, ma'am, in absentia. My cordial welcome to the backbone of our success, Principal Dr. M. Karthikeyan sir, who constantly support us for our institute and growth. Welcome you, sir, in absentia. With our fresh thoughts, optimistic approaches and gentle behavior, we are sure that this in book. Hence, my hearty to welcome Dr. D. Kumaresan sir, Director, for his continued support and encouragement, 7-day faculty development program in rich manner. Welcome you, sir. It's truly an excellent opportunity for learning under your guidance. It's my pleasure to welcome our chief guest, Dr. P. Malyadri, MCOM, PhD, PGDCA, ICSSR Senior Fellow, Research Advisor in Management and Commerce, Center for Economic and Social Studies in and ICSSR Research Institute, Ministry of HRD, Government of India, Hyderabad, and the second day of Faculty Development Program. Welcome you, sir. I would like to trusted welcome the respected head of the department, Mr. O. Obalikrishnan. Welcome you, sir. My warm welcome to all the participants and my colleagues who have come forward to attend this 7-day faculty development program. Welcome you all. Once again, welcome you all. Have a great day.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your warm welcome. To be inspired is great. To be inspired is great, but to be an inspiration is an honor. May I now request Mr. M. Shankar sir, Assistant Professor of BCom Department, KSA Women's College, to introduce our Honorable Chief Guest. Please, sir.
Good morning to everyone present here. And a warm welcome. It gives me a great pleasure to welcome you all for 7-day virtual faculty development program on multidimensional approach to research social science organized by PG Department of Commerce. I feel proud to introduce today's chief guest, Dr. P. Malyadri, in front of this noble gathering. I heartily welcome you, sir. He is acting as an ICSSR Senior Fellow Research Advisor in Management and Commerce. He did doctorate in commerce in 1991 from Sri Venkateswara University. He enacted services with 33 years of experience of teaching, research, administration, training and consultancy. He has authored 6 books and 143 research papers in various national and international journals of reputed, including Scopus Index. He is a peer team member, Assessor NAC. He has presented several research papers in around 100 national and international seminars and conferences. He is on the International Editorial Board as a member in 354 internet. He also reviewed more than 2,000 articles for the international. He is a regular advisor to guide MPhil and PhD students in the Department of Commerce and Business Management. He has delivered keynote address at 3 international conferences held at Kuala Lumpur, Sri Lanka and Bangkok. Dr. Malyadri is presently member Academic Advisory Board, Arunachal University, Dehradun. He also recognized PhD scholars in the Department of Commerce and Management, Bharathiya University, Coimbatore, Kanchi University, Kanchipuram, Tamil Nadu. He served as a program officer of the National Service Scheme for 5 years and conducted several programs and received outstanding awards. He got an award of senior fellowship from ICSSR New Delhi and is presently as a ICSSR senior fellow at the Center for Economic and Social Studies, Hyderabad. He is also serving as inspecting authorities appointed by Ministry of Minority Affairs, Government of India, to conduct inspection of the NGOs, institutions, skills development centers across the country for 2 years. He received several outstanding awards for his academic achievements. He has awarded the Best Teacher Awards, Best Teacher Award by the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh in the year of 2008 on the special occasion of Teachers Day. He has currently research interests including CRM, bank marketing, finance, rural development, human resource management, entrepreneurial development and strategic management. He has visited several countries, Malaysia, Sri Lanka, Thailand. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you so much for your pleasant introduction, sir. I know all are itching to hear the valuable words of our chief guest. Without making any hand over the session to our chief guest, sir. Now the session is yours, please, sir.
Thank you very much. Is it audible?
Yes, professor.
Okay. So very good morning to all the participants. I am extremely to associate with KSR College, KSR Women's College, and I am very much thankful to the chairman and vice chairman. Really, they are doing a wonderful yeoman service for the academic excellence. and thankful to Kartikeyan, principal, and also Dr.
Mic is muted.
No, sir, your mic is muted, I think.
Yeah. I am really thankful to Dr. Kumaresan for inviting me for this wonderful session to interact with the young scholars. In fact, Dr. Kumaresan is a man presentation, a wonderful presentation which is useful to the young scholar. I really proud of him for his excellent presentation. I had many times I had an interaction with Kumaresan sir. He has given he got good skills, aptitude, good research in aptitude, good aptitude in research. And the tomorrow's resource person, Dr. Kankipati Srinivas Rao, and other young friends. Today, I'm going to speak about the review of literature and the protection from plagiarism. Yesterday, Dr. Kumaresan has given a wonderful insights about the PhD program and how to identify the topic. Now, after identifying the topic, what is your job? That I will discuss at length now. After identification of the topic, you need to collect more and more literature, more and more articles related to your topic. So naturally, you have to collect the information relating to for getting general idea, and also identifying the research gap so that we may be able to set the research objectives and hypotheses. So therefore, you need to collect number of articles, more number of articles, more number of research studies, so that you may be able to write the literature review very, very effectively. Now, I will share the document and extract PPT. Is it
Ah, yes, professor, yes.
Thank you.
Looks very nice.
Welcome to the participants of 7-day FDP conducted by ESR College of Arts and Sciences, Parbhuman, which is affiliated to Periyar University. Today, I am going to discuss review of literature and protection from plagiarism. Now, I will speak about the literature and then how to protect from the plagiarism. I will discuss it later. I think the second slide is visible now. Second slide is visible.
Yes, Professor, visible, visible.
Okay. Now, I will brief you about what is meant by literature. Because you are all the research scholars, you know, please make a note that everybody talks about review of literature, review of literature. Now, you should know what is literature. So, literature means it is a collection of number of articles which are related to your topic. That is most important. Once you have chosen a topic, you are supposed to collect a lot of articles, a large number of articles, so that you will have an idea. Because you have to get you have to generate some ideas on your topic, and only you may be able to go further. So naturally, the literature may be obtained from primary sources and secondary sources. What are the primary sources? It is a first-hand information. So you might be collected from various research studies. So research studies, we may call it as empirical studies. So many evaluation studies are there. You can go to Google, type your title, and make a title before the title evaluation study or research study. You will get abundant number of research studies. So you have to collect various research studies related to your topic. So that is all comes under primary sources. And secondary sources means it is purely based upon the secondary data information. So some articles may be published on your topic on the basis of secondary data. That is called as secondary data. This also you are supposed to collect. So basically what I can say not a secondary database evidence, we don't have any more relevance. So you know, I say that secondary based studies are just like a postmortem report. I simply say that it is a postmortem report. And many finance departments, the faculty members are identifying a topic related to secondary database. There is no importance. But however, sometimes on the basis of the secondary data, especially in finance department, they may make some projections that is also useful, but we need empirical evidence. We need empirical evidence. What is going on in the grassroots level? That is most important. So that we may be able to know the inputs at the grassroots level, and we may be able to provide good solutions for taking decisions. See, you know, there are the three stakeholders are waiting for our research inferences. What are the three stakeholders? One government, two society, three industry. These are all waiting for our inferences, our study inferences. Which are useful to the industry? Which are useful to the government for taking better decisions? Are the betterment of the society? Research, good research is undoubtedly useful for the betterment of the society. Why literature? Earlier I told you that you are supposed to learn something about your topic, and you are supposed to collect various studies so that you may be able to decide the objectives, what to do, what not to do, where to do, how to do. All these things can by only through development. So to make a base for research, so and I already told you that you need to gain some knowledge in the field of the specific topic, of the specific area, and what is the progress on the topic. That is also most important work for them to know. And you should make sure that you are in right path. And also you are supposed to examine what are the previous studies, and are there the different methodological issues that also you have to go through, because you are supposed to set methodological issues, you have to set the methodology for your study. Suppose if you've gone through some of the studies related to methodological issues, it is very easier to set the methodology of your research study. And you will have to identify with the help of you will have to identify the research gap with the help of the metric. And finally, with the help of the gap, you will have many, many investigational issues with the help of the investigation in there it was not already covered, because if at all already covered, you need not to cover now. If it is already covered, you leave it. What are the new areas? What are the investigation areas? On the basis of that, you have to tell it. And finally, to relate your results and publish in your papers. What are the steps involved in the challenge? So, you have to search for good sources.
Excuse me, Professor. Your mic is muted, I think. Professor? Excuse me, Professor?
Yeah.
Yeah, your mic is muted. Please.
Is it okay?
No, it's okay. It's okay now. Okay now.
Is it visible, PPT?
It's going on. It will be coming within a few seconds.
PPT is not visible, sir.
PPT is not visible?
Yes, it's going on, Professor. It will be viewed.
Is it visible?
Not yet, Professor.
Is it visible?
No, sir. It's not visible.
No. It's not visible, Professor. Not yet.
Now it is visible, sir.
Yes.
It is fully visible?
It is in the presentation mode. Okay, Professor, you can start. You can continue.
Just a minute, I will try.
Not visible.
I hope it is visible now.
Yes, Professor. Yes, Professor. Thank you.
Visible, sir. Very much.
So now we are in the, yes, in the slide on steps involved in literature review. Is it okay?
Yes, Professor. Yes, yes.
Okay. Now, what are the steps involved in literature review? I will brief you. I already explained about the good sources, and you have to sort out the various papers, because the many papers you might be collected and you might be saved in your desktop, but you have to sort out it relating to different issues, different areas, different problems. Like that, you have to sort out it and then you read the papers. You read and read. Once you read several times, definitely you may be able to write on your own, making some notes, and you critically analyze the issues, different issues, and analyze and highlight. And you make a note of different comparative studies, and finally you set some boundaries. Because once you set boundaries, then only you may be able to come out in preparing the review of studies very effectively. Otherwise, if there are no boundaries, I think your entire stipulation period will be always going on collecting literature, collecting literature. There is a need of putting some boundaries. You brief you your wonderful ideas how to write literature. You have to collect the studies related to your topic for the last 10 years only. Better not go beyond 10 years. Because
Mr. Bio,
hello?
It's not audible properly. It's not audible, sir.
It's audible, ma'am. Ma'am, it is audible. Please check your device. You can increase the volume of your device.
Your voice I can hear, but the guest is, the speaker wise I can't hear, sir. Your voice it's clearly audible.
Okay, ma'am. We are able to hear his voice, ma'am.
Yes, yes. Clearly I could hear.
Okay, thank you.
So, you have to collect the studies for the last 10 years only, not beyond 10 years, because majority of the study, maybe majority of the topics are updated topics, latest topics, current topics. So therefore, we need not the oldest material. Next, you have to identify some documents, relevant documents, both published and unpublished. So I already told you that you understand the concept of the paper. Read the papers several times, not one time, two times, three times. Many times if you can read, you may be able to write on your own. That is most important. You cannot copy the study findings directly. You must write on your own. Put the major points. What are the major points in the paper, in the study, that you have to examine and write out. So it will be a mini reckoner by providing references. References are also to be written out of it. So we are going to through the evaluation study before, the study before, to summarize, because that is most important. You summarize in a paper, in a page, in two pages, and you find out what are the conclusions, so that because collecting the literature is a continuity, you finalize the topic. You are supposed to collect many, many studies, and you have to update by the submission of your thesis. And what I advise you is, please always refer top scientific index journals, like Scopus index journals, like Web of Science journals, like ABDC, like FT50 is Financial Times 50. So top 50 journals in the world,
So you refer the articles because majority of the journals are open access journals. So you can go through the articles at free of cost. So you have tremendous opportunity to go through the open access material, open access articles. Next one. Avoid conference articles and edited book articles. Okay, I am just advising you to avoid, as far as possible, avoid citing the conference articles, citing the book articles. What I have to say is, say that the studies which are published, the available studies which are published in conference articles, edited articles, or in edited book, try to avoid it. You can go through the articles which are published in journals only, top index journals. Next, references with DOI. What is DOI? Digital Object Identifier. Yes. For every article after 2000, every article is given one doubling. That is called DOI. It is a permanent doubling. For every article, you are supposed to provide DOI. If you provide DOI, it is given priority. Majority of the Scopus Index journals, they give top priority for the DOI. So, for every article followed by, you are supposed to provide DOI link. If you click DOI link, automatically your article PDF link will be appears. So, as far as possible, you refer DOI link those articles. Read and write on your own. Yes. You have to read the article several times. And avoid plagiarism. So plagiarism can be avoided by reading and reading. Use paraphrasing. Paraphrasing, it can be shorter and simply, and you will get greater clarity. Use scholarcy.com. So this scholarship.com is useful for you for summarizing the text without any plan. So it detects, it helps you in providing new care. Yes. Recording your need. So of course you have collected many studies, many articles. So whenever you collect the article, you note down the author, title of the paper, data of publication that is month, quarter, year, like that you are supposed to collect. If it is a book, that is also good mentioned. If it is a chapter, it is good, but also typing, later, such information is required. If it is a paper, it is a journal, the title of the journal, volume, issue number and pages to the image, and a website that is called weblink. Weblink is also to be provided. There you have access. So that is also most important. Source of literature review. These are the different sources. You are all aware of all this. You can have our books. You can refer research paper, these are all the sources. You can go through these all the sources and collect the information. Types of sources are different. So earlier I told you about the primary sources, secondary sources, primary sources are it is directly the original source of information. Secondary sources is only available in textbooks or edited books or media research, etc. And the tertiary sources means it is available in dailies, indexes, handbooks, some harmonics. These are all the comes under the tertiary sources. Now, after collecting the information, you are supposed to prepare the research gap. What are the different research gaps that you have to identify and provide insights of the gap? many studies are conducted, many studies are there with you, many documentaries are with you, many investigational issues are already it is there with you. Now, what are the issues you are going to cover? In that, you are supposed to cover all this evidence gap. What is the evidence? Research evidence. Many evidences are there for finding the topic. What is the meaning? That is a gap. Knowledge. You may be gone through about your article, you got new knowledge. But what is the what is your knowledge? A new knowledge. That is the gap. What is the practical knowledge? Is it a practical? That also be you are supposed to do. And the methodological gap. See, different studies adopted different methodologies. So, what you are going to adopt? You should not copy the previous methodology, previous studies methodology. You are supposed to identify the new methodology. And the empirical gap. See, the empirical evidence. What is the empirical evidence? In different studies you have collected, you have studied, now what type of empirical evidence you are going to get. Like that theoretical gap. And population. Population gap means sampling. In previous studies, what is the size of the sample? One study, the size of the sample may be 100, in another study 200, in another study 350, but what you are going to do? For if you are going to be at least 400 samples, you adopt, you select 400 to 500 samples. For MPhil, of course, new education policy, MPhil is like it. So, like that, you have to cover all these disciplines. Next, I'm coming to plugins. It is a big problem now. Because earlier, we get that there is no open access. People are copying the material and writing the articles. People are copying the material and preparing the thesis. Nobody knows. Now, there is a software of one result. If you submit thesis, first of all, it should be sent to the plagiarism talk. And it will be tested. As per the UGC norm, at least there should not be more than 30% of plagiarism. Some universities are adapted below 10%. More than 30% not allowed in some universities. Like that, you are supposed to follow as per the norms of the university. Now, I will brief you about plagiarism and how to adapt, how to escape from this plagiarism, how best you may be able to write the thesis very effectively without a plagiarism or below 10% plagiarism. What is a plagiarism? I will give you. Plagiarism means it is a theft. It is derived from Latin word that is plagium. It is known as theft. So if you steal the information from other source, some other words, that will be called as plagiarism. Without telling the source, of course, you can grab some information, but you are supposed to provide the source. If you want to provide any source, that is also permitted under plagiarism. Please make a note that your thesis will be entire draft cannot be sent to plagiarism software. Your references should be deleted. Right? Only chapter 1 to chapter 6. Only that content part will be sent to plagiarism software and it will be tested. Reference part, your question and everything will be removed. Right? So it is if you can steal any information or original idea. From the existing source that is called plagiarism. What is the consideration of it? So if you copy 6 words at a time in a row without quoting, you get plagiarism. Understand? So you cannot copy 6 words at a time. If you copy 6 words, automatically it happens to be plagiarized. So, showing someone else's work, I don't know. So, if you can show some information stating that you will be your work, it will be considered as a plagiarized. So, copying words or ideas in someone else without giving them, that is already told. Failing to put a quotation. So, if you provide the quotation, that should also be stored, given otherwise it comes under the point. Giving incorrect information about the source of quotation. If you provide quotation without proper information, without proper source, that may be called as a problem. So changing words but copying the sentence structure of a source without giving credit, that also a problem. So you can change the sentence structure, but it should not be copied with the 6 words. Copying so many words or ideas from source that it makes up the majority of your work, whether you do it or not. So using an image, suppose if you copy image, if you copy a video or a piece of music in your work, definitely that is also considered as a plagiarism, but unless if you show the citation, that is reference. What are the different types of plagiarism? Let me brief about the different types. Direct copy, if you copy directly without any reference, that is a direct copy. Verbatim reproduction, so without any citation if you produce the same, that is called verbatim reproduction. Idea plagiarism, if you can steal the ideas from others, that is also another type. Word switch, paraphrasing. Word switch means sometimes the words, same words if you don't copy, but some words may be slipped. That may be another type of plagiarism. Patchwork, you know about patchwork. You can collect some information, you can copy some information, two or three lines in one article, two or three lines in another article, like that. Patchwork, that is also one type of plagiarism. Cyber plagiarism. Cyber means it is going to internet. If you copy it, the internet material also comes under the plagiarism. Reverse plagiarism. Sometimes you may copy and write in reverse manner, that also comes under the plagiarism. Self plagiarism. Suppose if you publish one article, if you quote the same, by same, if you can copy, that is also self comes under the self plagiarism. Even if you want to quote your same reference which are already published, but you cannot copy the same. If you copy it, automatically it attracts. So what you have to do, you have to write again on your own, differently, to avoid the problem. So accidental plagiarism, you don't know, you might be copying somewhere, and that may be called as accidental plagiarism. Incorrect citation. Sometimes you may provide the information on your own, but citation is wrong. If citation is wrong, definitely it also leads to plagiarism. Why do writers plagiarize? Why people are copying? People are copying from various sources, various books, various reports, various journals, various conference articles, because the lack of writing skills. Due to lack of skills, they often don't depend on past knowledge. Because when you copy, you are supposed to depend on past knowledge. What you have to do, already you have collected the studies, then you copy. No. Past knowledge is required to substantiate the arguments. On the basis of the past knowledge, you are supposed to provide your arguments, then you can escape from the argument. Targeting citations. Citations are always careful you are supposed to quote. Assuming that internet source is free. No. Don't assume that internet source is free. All internet source which may attract the plagiarism. The software will detect the internet source also. Do you think that only copying articles in journal articles, it is an attractive plagiarism? No. If you can copy internet source, any internet source or blogs, architectures, if you copy, definitely it attracts. Ignorance. Some people, they don't know if I copy no issue. And they think like that. It is only ignorance. Laziness or arrogance. That also leads to copying the material. It is easy. People think that it is easy to copy. No. Faculty is effective. Because faculty those who are working in colleges, they are not provided internet, they are not provided computer. So naturally they try to steal the information and write this time. A problem. Now I will brief you what are the issues and the consequences. If you copy or you steal the information, many issues are there, punishments are there. Be careful. If you copy, you will be given punishment. I will quote some of the consequences. Dr. CNN Rao, ex-director IASE, is a scientific advisor to PM. He tendered apology for copying and publishing the journal, the article in 2004. One German minister recently, this is the recent news, one German minister who copied some information for his thesis, for her thesis, is a lady. She resigned from the minister post. One ex-CEC, Delhi University, sent to jail for copying the information. Professor Chandra Krishnamurti, Vice Chancellor, Pondicherry University, in 2015, he removed from the Vice Chancellor post. Professor Vinay Kumar Patak, NPJ Abdul Kalam University, Lucknow, is also same question. He was removed. So, these are the consequences. You please be careful. You gave the issues related to plagiarism, what are the consequences. Student reputation. Definitely, the reputation will be spoiled among the students, and it also bad name to the issue. It is called a professional reputation, academic reputation. It will be spoiled. And sometimes students will be suspended. So, therefore, all the faculty members. Since the stage of the student only, they should be given more information about the problem. And only it is possible by the student, the people, research level, they can do, they can follow the ethical issue. And there is a copyright act, 1957, that is also the very serious. And there are many consequences for the economy also. Monetary repercussions also being given to the staff member. Sometimes expulsion also leaves and ethics. So, plagiarized research, it also leaves lots of people in favor of the media. Suppose a doctor, please some information.
Professor?
Hello?
Excuse me, your voice is low, Professor.
Okay. I will raise.
Yeah.
In fact, I am not reducing my voice. It is a continuous.
Okay.
I think it may be some technical issue.
Yeah.
Next.
If you can come closer to the device, it will be better, I think. Okay, or else you can use the earphone.
Next, ways and means of protection from plagiarism. Now, it is most important because everybody watch about how we will be able to protect from plagiarism. Read and understand the original document. I told you several times that you are supposed to read and read, understand, evaluation study, the original document, the original article, original report, the original book, original conference article. If you understand it, definitely you will be able to write on your own. Do proper citation to all the sources. Yes, you are supposed to provide the citations. If you provide citations, definitely it may not attract the plagiarism. Paraphrasing. You can go to Google, type paraphrasing. If you have some information relating to evaluation study of one page, copy one page, paste it in paraphrasing, you will get one new page which is 100% plagiarism. But again, you have to read the page content, because the content sometimes may be changed, the meaning sometimes may be changed. Again, you have to make edit with the help of the paraphrasing tool which is available in Google. Present your own idea. That I already told you that you are supposed to present your own idea only through reading. Use a plagiarism checker time to time in Google. If you have page or one page, you can check it up with the plagiarism checker. Your own insights, that is most important. Own insights are most powerful. Your own insights, your own words. No issue, grammar is not a problem, use grammar. There is a Grammarly software. You can check through Grammarly software. You can make corrections. Rewriting, many times you can write. Proofreading is only meant for just the final commas or any spelling issues or like that, you can make it. Rectify. Change the sentence structure. You are copied 6 words at a time. You change it. If you can change it, you can words make substitute. Definitely plagiarism. And finally, write and rewrite again, and then revise. So, going on writing the drafts 2 times, 3 times, there will be zero of plagiarism. Okay? So, all these you take care of. These issues, and definitely you can protect from the 4 R's of paraphrasing. Reword, replace with synonyms, because in paraphrasing you need to give someone synonyms with the correct meaning, that you have to take it. Rearrange, try to rearrange the order of sentences without disturbing the meaning. You realize that some information which cannot be changed, that is name, title, in which year it was published, that cannot be changed. Recheck. So you have to recheck whether the sentences given in paraphrase from the source paper. So there may be lot of changes through paraphrasing because of reducing the plagiarism. The meaning is changed or not, you have to check it out. So, 9 steps to effective paraphrasing. Read the research paper several times. Set the original aside and write your paraphrase on a note card. Jot down few words below your paraphrase to remind you later how you plan using this degree. So at the top of the note card, write keywords and related to different issues. Compare the length of what you have written to the original text. So you have to compare with the original text and paraphrasing information. Use quotation marks to identify any unique term. Record the source, including page number and your note card. Include a text citation in the expected formatting style. See, different formatting styles are adopted. So which one generally you have to follow the Vitality journal, journal paraphrasing system you have to adopt into the university, what type of formatting style you are supposed to adopt. Need to give credit to the author. So citation is most important. Without citation it cannot be done. A strategic approach for reducing plagiarism consists of four components. First is education. See, we have to educate the people at the student level only about the plagiarism. Prevention. We have to prevent it at student level only. And only you may be able to detect and use to prevent. So these are all the softwares available for plagiarism check. Check writing, copying, DrillBit, DupliCheckr, EasyBit, Ginger, Authenticate, PaperRater, many software plagiarism checkers are there. Some of them are available in Google at free of cost. As per the UGC norms, there are three important major popular plagiarism check software. That is, I have given in the color, Turnitin, Murkun and Authenticate. So with the help of three plagiarism softwares, the university may check your thesis, your text, and then they will decide whether you submit or not. If it is below 10% or 30%, you are allowed to submit. Otherwise, again, you will be. So before going to before going to submit thesis, you have to check it offline. Then you are safe. So therefore, even for Scopus Index journals or Web of Science journals, immediately after receiving the article, they will check it up with the help of Authenticate, with the help of the site, Turnitin, or with the help of the course. So you take care of writing your thesis or any article through this plagiarism software, and be careful. So my presentation about review of literature and protection from plagiarism. This is my WhatsApp number. If anybody wants to send messages, I will give the reply. Now open to discussion. Over to the organizers. Thank you. Thank you very much for the
Gopika, you can continue.
Okay, sir. We are thankful for your crystal clear explanation and presentation, sir. I do not pretend we have all the answers, but the questions are certainly worthy thinking about. Now, this is the time for question session. Dear participants, if you have any queries, you can unmute your mic or you can ask through the chat box. On the other hand, our secret weapon for building the best culture is open and honest feedback. Dear participants, the feedback link is given in the chat box. You are requested to fill it and submit. Thank you.
So now open to the scholars. Any questions, you most welcome. Or you can WhatsApp the information to me. I will ready to give the answers because I like research very much. It is my passion.
Sir, one question is there in the chat box.
Yeah.
Can we use Authenticate free of cost as a researcher?
No. Authenticate is not at all a free. It is not a, it cannot be available in Google. It is 100% cost price.
Sir, one more question.
Comes under the Tumpin organization.
Okay. Related to that. Okay, professor. One more question for the participants. Could you mention about the free softwares for plagiarism check? That I think they listed out plagiarism software, sir.
I listed out first 4-5 softwares are apparently free.
Okay.
They can say, for example, log checker. It is apparently free in Google, but you cannot take more number of pages.
Pages.com. Okay. Dear participants, do you have any other question?
Please allow the participants to speak.
Dear participants, you can directly ask questions to the professor. One by one, you can unmute and you can ask directly to the resource person.
Why these scholars are very silent in the case of because majority of the scholars are stealing the information silently.
I think they are filled with joy with your wonderful presentation.
Yeah. I hope everybody understood.
In paraphrasing, sir, for reference note and all, we have a style, sir. So, do we have any style of writing the review of literature, sir?
Or what?
For a writing review of literature, sir. So like MLA style and many other styles are having, no?
Yeah.
Do you have particular thing to follow, sir?
Depending upon the subjects. Say, if it is languages, MLA style. If it is engineering, IEEE. Depending upon the subjects, the citation styles, the formatting styles will be changed.
So mostly we can follow that MLA style only. Is it enough, sir?
No, we cannot say that MLA style can be adopted. It's all depending upon the requirements by the university or requirements by the journal. So you have to go through the journal guidelines. You have to go through the, suppose if you want to publish an article in a journal, go through the guidelines, which formatting style they need, you are supposed to follow it. Or otherwise, if you want to submit your thesis, which type of formatting style we are supposed to submit, you have to follow it.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good morning. Sir, I have a question about the literature of review, sir. This is Sangeeta. I'm doing my PhD, sir, research scholar. I have completed 2 years of PhD. I'm in a third year. Sir, I need an important question about that. Where we get the latest literature review, sir? Because when we write the literature review, our professors and our guide told me that we need to provide the latest literature review, which is comes latest last 5 years or last 3 years. So in that case, do we have any particular platform or any particular website to get the latest literature review for our guidelines, sir?
No. There is no specific platform. There is no specific website. You are supposed to was supposed to go through many internet sources, many libraries. Say, for example, you can go to university libraries also. You can make use of the internet sources. As I told you, DOI, Digital Object Identifier.
Okay.
It was introduced in 2000. So after 2000, you will get DOI linked references. Right? So you always follow.
Making this program a resounding one. Nobody is exempt from the problem of life. Everyone will face it maybe today or tomorrow. But we can find something positive in everything, even in the worst time. Remember, we can still make something beautiful and powerful out of a really bad situation. It is in our hands to make progress for that. With these sound waves, I would like to end this program with a gratitude. Again, thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Let me be grateful to the people who make us happy today. You are the charming gardeners who make our souls blossom. Once again, a hearty thanks to everyone for today's session. Our third golden day is tomorrow by our resourceful person, Dr. Kankipati Srinivasa Rao, on the topic of significance of questionnaire and its framework. All please stay tuned. We'll catch you all again tomorrow. Until then, it's a big bye from KSR Women's College, Tiruchengodu. Thank you all again. Thank you.